Welcome, viewers. Today we are going to do chapter 2, which is methods of inquiry in psychology. We'll be doing experimental method today and along with that correlation method. Experiment is a very unique method, not just to psychology, but a lot of scientific research. Experiment as a method basically means understanding the relation between cause and effect. So there has to be a reason and there has to be a consequence. So cause and effect, remember this word, cause and effect relationship is being studied. That's the same thing which is mentioned in the definition also. Now this cause is being manipulated by the experimenter or the researcher. That's the same thing which we call as changing the cause or manipulating the cause. That is the change or the manipulation. Now, we have an experimental method, the concept of a variable. Variable means anything that varies or takes on different values. Eye color can have different values, hair color can have different values, pens can be of different kinds. That's a variable. So, for every research, we can have a different variable in different degree and quantity. We have three kinds of variables here. Independent variable, dependent variable, and extraneous variable. Now, the purpose of research is basically to enhance the effect of independent variable on dependent variable and to reduce the third one, which is extraneous variable. Let's understand what are these three kinds of variable. Independent variable, a variable or condition of an event which is selected by the experimenter for manipulation or variation. For example, teacher's classroom behavior is an independent variable which affects the student's performance. So that is IV, that we call as the cause. If we are trying to use five different teaching methods in five different classrooms, that is an independent variable. IV, the cause which is manipulated. For instance, when we talk about a study done by Latanya and Darley in the Columbia University, now what they did was they tried to highlight that does the number of people present in a room increase the amount of reporting of a smoke. We'll just remember this title. I'll explain that in context of the three kinds of variables and the rest of the experiment. Second is dependent variable. Now, what we measure, what we study, the impact that we get is basically the dependent variable. One is the cause which is being manipulated, which is the IV. The DV or the dependent variable is the impact or the outcome, the consequence that we have, which we measure scientifically. The basic idea of experiment is to understand the impact of IV on DV. That is the goal of research. But in case the third variable comes into picture, then it dilutes the study. Dependent variable, a variable or condition of an event on which the effect of IV is observed and measured. For example, the level of anxiety is dependent variable, which is affected by the increase in the level of peer pressure. If we increase the peer pressure, that's a cause which is going to increase the amount of anxiety. So peer pressure, anxiety. So peer pressure is the cause, anxiety is the effect. Just remember these words which are important. IV is the cause, and that comes in the beginning, which is manipulated by the researcher. The impact which is measured is the DV, which is the effect. Third is the extraneous variable. Now this is a very, very irrelevant variable. Variables which are other than the IV. And that has an impact on the research will spoil the research. So the basic idea is to control these variables so that the better impact of IV is on DV. Variables other than IV, which define the dependent variable and influence the results of the study and make the interpretation of findings difficult. So obviously these have to be controlled. For instance, if the researcher is working on a research study like Latanya and Darley were studying, in that particular experiment, the amount of smoke was an extraneous variable. Now, the smoke of different kind, the speed of smoke, all these variables had to be controlled so that in all the rooms, the same amount of smoke goes and there's no change in the impact because of the amount of smoke. So that was the extraneous variable. Now, to control the impact of extraneous variable, we have five techniques. The first technique is known as elimination. Elimination, for instance, I am wanting to eliminate the impact of sound. So what will I do is I will develop a soundproof room so that I eliminate totally the impact of this extraneous variable of noise. Second is holding the behavior constant. Now, a particular behavior, if I have to hold constant, let's say I have to hold gender constant. So, in that case, I am going to use only one gender, but obviously that would mean I cannot apply my findings to the other gender. So, that research will be limited, but that does control this extraneous variable. Third is matching, a very interesting technique. Now, here what is done is different levels are matched. For example, I have to take a variable which is within me of intelligence. I take three groups: high intelligent, low intelligent, and average intelligent. Similarly, I pick up for three groups, I pick up high intelligent from one, low intelligent from one, average from one. So, what I am doing is I am matching the three groups, I am picking on from all the three groups and matching this variable of intelligence. Similar can happen for socioeconomic status. Suppose I have to take high class, high social class, average social class, and middle social class. So, I will pick on all these three and form groups accordingly. Next technique is counterbalancing technique. Counterbalancing is basically sequence effect. When you are doing an experiment, you go in a particular order. Let's say there are two variables or two conditions, A and B. We go in an order A, B, A, B. Now, here what happens is monotony sets in, tiredness sets in, boredom sets in, repetition sets in, memory sets in. Therefore, to control the sequential variable, we change the order, which is unpredictable. So, instead of A, B, A, B, we go A, B, B, A. This obviously will not be predictable. It will cut down on all the negatives of same sequence repetition. Last method is random assignment. Now, this particular method says that we divide the groups. Suppose it's a lottery system. It's more simple to explain. It's a lottery system. I put all the names of children who are going to participate in a debate. I put their names in a bowl and I pick out in a very unbiased manner, so that there is no discrimination. One child will not come up and tell me, ma'am, you did not choose me. The other child will not say that you preferred the other child. So, therefore, this is a very unbiased system where the whole sample is selected in a manner that everybody is given a fair chance. Everybody gets a chance to represent themselves. That is the last step. Let's move on. We have two concepts, experimental and control groups. Now, this is a very important concept again. Experimental group basically says the group where we are using the independent variable. So, in the group that independent variable is used, that is experimental group. In the group that which is exactly the same as the experimental group, that is a control group, except for the addition of independent variable. So, independent variable is not there, that is the only change. Otherwise, the two groups are exactly similar. So, what will happen and why are we taking these two groups is because if the result is the same in both the groups, obviously, we know there was no impact of IV on DV. If the result is different, we know because it's a control group which is telling us that IV wasn't there, still the impact is the same. So, therefore, IV did not have the impact on DV. That is the whole idea. Now, in the Latane-Darley experiment, let me tell you all the concepts. The basic factor of IV here, independent variable, was the number. There were three rooms in which the participants were sent. The first room was where nobody was present. So, that nobody was present was a control group. Second group where the people were present who were responding to what the experimenter was saying. If the experimenter was saying go and report the smoke, the amount of smoke entering the room, they were reporting it. If the experimenter was saying don't report, they were not. So, they were listening to what the experimenter was saying. Third group again had people who were not exactly going and reporting the smoke because experimenter had told them to do so. So, these were the three groups. Now, in these three groups, the amount of smoke was exactly the same. Now, in this research study, what was done was the participants were sent and told that your interview will be taken. And there was a questionnaire given to them, a question list given to them, they had to fill it up. And when they were filling it up, automatically smoke filled the room. They were not prepared for that. So, in the group where there was nobody, maximum number of reporting happened. This was the control group. Because there was no IV here, so there was no impact. Maximum reporting happened. Second group where the confederates or the researchers, people were there, they did not go and report the experiment. Again, the reporting of the people reduced. This was the impact of IV on DV. reporting was actually the DV, so that it reduced when the number of people were less. So number of people was the cause, reporting was the effect. Number of people IV, reporting was the DV. And of course that was variable because experimenters' own people did not report it. Looking at them, the actual experimentees also did not go and report. Let's look at the types of experiments. There are two major types of experiments, field experiments and quasi experiments. Field experiments happen in a laboratory, in a very controlled setting, in a setting which is actually meant for that particular experiment. That's a field experiment. Quasi experiment is basically talking about as if experimentation. After an earthquake, obviously the earthquake cannot be created. The variable here cannot be manipulated. The variable can only be selected. That is quasi-experimentation, where there cannot be any change, any modification, whatever is there. Only groups can be divided, variable can be selected, and that's about the experimental study. Let's move on to the advantages and the disadvantages of experimental method. Convincing evidence of cause and effect relationship. That is the beauty of an experimental method. We are basically trying to study the cause and the effect. It's a very strong prediction, very accurate prediction, very scientific prediction of cause and effect relationship. It's a very good scientific method, very well designed scientific method, therefore results are very good. It is very accurate. It is highly controlled, therefore again accuracy increases. Disadvantage, of course, it is very artificial as a method, because here we are getting the subjects in a laboratory, setting certain conditions, we are getting the subjects in a particular place, setting those conditions, so it is very artificial. You may not be applied to the real life setting. That is one major drawback of experimental method. That is why we say it can only stimulate certain conditions in a lab. You cannot have every kind of experiment in a lab. You can only have certain kinds of experiments in a lab. So that is a limitation of it. Low external validity, we obviously mean that you cannot generalize it, apply it to every setting. Not feasible for studying all kinds of problems. You cannot deprive people of food for 2 days and study them. That's very unethical again. You cannot give them electric shocks and study. That's again very unethical. Difficult to know and control all types of research variables. You cannot study everything. Let's move on to the next topic, which is correlational research. Now, the two methods, you can understand it together. Experiment studies, cause and effect relationship. Correlation studies, causal relationship. So, one was causal relationship, this is causal relationship. Basically means that the two variables happen to occur together. It is not that the two are causing each other, it is just that the two happen to occur together. So that one can be predicted with the other, but not always with a guarantee, because the two happen to occur together. For example, high amount of smoking and heart problems exist together. Now this is both the variables of the research are going together, but it may not happen that if one increases, the other also increases. That is a correlation method. Let's look at the major concepts of correlation. We have the degree and the direction of correlation. Degree basically means a perfect correlation, which is 1, and closest to that 0.80, 0.60, 50 is the 0.50 is the average correlation. Similar to that, we have the direction. Direction basically means the if both the variables increase, it's positive direction. If both the variables decrease, it's positive again. If one variable goes high and the other goes low, it's negative correlation. And if there's no relation, then it's zero correlation. That is about correlation method. Let's summarize. We talked about experimental method with the concepts of what is experiments, cause and effect. Then we had variable, IV, DV, extraneous variable. Extraneous had 5 kinds of control methods. Advantages, disadvantages, again we covered. Types of experiments we covered. And then we moved on to correlation methods and its basic relation with experimental method. That's about it for today. Thank you.